Hello folks, and welcome back to Mod of the Month, where we showcase some of the best builds completed over the last month over in the BitTech forums. Corsair has upped the ante and are providing a host of Hydro X themed goodies, with first place netting a choice of an XC9 or XC7 RGB CPU block, a choice of GPU block from their range, an XD5 RGB pump reservoir combo, and a Commander Pro. Second place gets a choice of CPU block and GPU block, and third gets a choice of CPU block. As ever, if you want to be in with a chance of taking part and netting some pretty awesome Corsair goodies, all you need to do is have a completed project log hosted over on the BitTech forums. Enjoy the builds. First up, congratulations to last month's modding update winner, which was Sputnik by Spic. It was actually a very close race last month, with Sputnik only pulling ahead by a single vote by the end. That said, it was clearly a crowd favourite, with the tricky design and neat execution winning over the voters. Now let's go and check out who's in it to win it for this month. Blackhawk is a scratch build based around the principle of not using a CNC for some reason. Well, whatever floats your boat, I suppose, but either way, it's a tricky project with a lot of hidden details and processes. The main structural core of the chassis is constructed from angled aluminium extrusions that have been bolted together, forming a framework to which the later panels are then added. Speaking of which, the additional panels were cut from acrylic and then sanded to form a matte surface, which was then later painted. Now, by adding LED strips behind the panels, this allows key points of the whole case to light up, which is quite an effective little mod and one he's used in his previous ones before this. Now, the inside of the system was kept nice and tidy via the use of an AlphaCool all-in-one cooler, along with the main components being modified to fit the theme. Ostrovac took on the challenge of completing his first scratch build with gusto. Choosing to use wood for the structure, he set to work designing a chassis that would slot into a smooth exterior. The bulk of the interior is made from plywood, which was then glued and screwed together and accented with pine pieces. Now, with two radiators hidden inside, airflow was always going to be an important consideration. So to work around this, he added large chambers around the radiators so that ample air would be able to reach them, often a sticking point for rigs where the vents are hidden. In addition to the woodwork, he's made use of 3D printing to construct many of the complex elements such as the I/O brackets, hard drive caddy, and dust filter holders. The hardware is then complemented by custom wiring, which was made from scratch, sleeved, and then cut to length in order to keep things clean and organized. The wires themselves were then passed through one by one through the panels of the case. Hi-Fi PC is a fun concept, taking an object that you're passionate about and then turning it into a fully functioning PC, whilst also maintaining the character and charm of both the original item and the PC components. Now, older audio amplifiers have really grown to become statements of industrial design, and as such are perfect candidates for PC mods, assuming that the internals are either beyond salvage or nothing special to begin with. Now, to accomplish this, Bourgeois made the motherboard tray out of copper sheet, and then went about theming the other components to match. For instance, the GPU cooler in particular was veneered and then placed on a riser cable in order to have enough clearance within the chassis. A nice touch is how the front knobs and buttons are actually still fully functional, with various lights and switches used for the I/O status, for the LEDs, and also the power switch and other functions. Now, if this was Mad's project for basic carpentry, then I think it's safe to say that we should be excited to see what he can accomplish when he's been in the field for even longer, because Beautiful Oak is a wonderfully classic piece of furniture that makes the most of the signature material, oak. Now, with the woodwork being its main focus, the fit and finish is superb. For instance, take a look at the finger joints on the PC shelf or the underside bevel that line up just perfectly and are beautifully flush. Now, the PC itself is clean and elegant thanks to having space under the motherboard tray in order to route all of the cables and other clutter. This is all then finished off with an appealing rigid tube water cooling setup that mirrors the angular approach of the desk. Now, there are consistent modders, and then there's AKMod, who I'm sure you'll remember from past Mod of the Months and of course Mod of the Year. Now, Antec's Striker chassis is not the easiest to work with owing to the peculiar shapes and scaling, so AK opted to rework it from the inside out. In order to jump from ITX all the way over to E80X to fit the X570 Aqua, he made a custom motherboard tray distro plate, which also incorporates the pump. This plate was interestingly enough made from acetal this time and then topped with acrylic, allowing it to have a black background with which to highlight the opaque pink coolant. With the rig themed around Cyberpunk 2077, pink and blue are abundant, although he's gone for the more muted approach this time. The rig is cooled via an extensive custom loop, with the radiator situated on the back of the chassis. AK's mods are rife with details, ranging from the custom lighting panels and logo features, all the way down to even the window spaces, which had to be remade in order to reposition the panel further out. Remember, if you'd like to be in with the chance of taking part and potentially winning some Corsair Hydro X gear, you just need to have a completed project log over on the BitTech forums. Be warned though, we do like to see the progress, so get in there early, show us the journey, because that's where the magic happens. Now it goes without saying, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe, as modding really is our jam. We're going to have plenty more project logs, part reviews and tutorials on the way, and you really don't want to miss out. You can also find us over on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and builds.gg. And definitely don't forget to pop into our Discord server linked below, as it's the best way to stay up to date with all the modding talk, plus I've heard we're not half bad to chat to. Now take care folks, and I'll catch you next time.